Hey guys, we're going to show you the bypass for the new Pioneer AVH-P4200DVD. Okay, so we're going to show you what happens. I got a movie in here. I got a switch for the key. So this is going to simulate turning the key on. Movie's in. This is not bypassed. When you turn the key on, this is what you see if it's not bypassed. This is the error message you see. Viewing's prohibited. Okay? So what we're gonna do is bypass this. And I'll show you how. First, let's take a look at the back of the unit. I'll explain some of these connections. This brown plug right here, brown RCA in, is for your rear view camera. These are your rear pre-outs. So this is the rear pre-out for an amplifier. This is the front pre-out for the amplifier. And this is a subwoofer pre-out. This is new to the 4200. This wasn't on the previous model, which was the 4100. This is a navigation input, so you can add navigation to this unit, which is really cool. These three plugs right here are audio and video inputs, so you can hook up a video game system, PS3 or Xbox 360 or something. You got your video in and your audio in. Here you have a rear video out for a rear screen. And over here there's a rear audio out, so you can hook up like a wireless headphone transmitter to it. This is a wired remote input. That'll let you integrate your factory steering wheel controls into this unit to work it. This is the IP bus in. This is for adding XM or Sirius satellite radio. This over here is an auxiliary in, so you have a 3.5 in. And here's a USB input for the iPod cable. And here's your power harness. And this green wire is the parking brake wire. Okay? Now, you can't just permanently ground this, because what's going to happen is, if the unit turns on when this is grounded, it's going to give you that same error message. We need to ground this after the unit's on. Some people you could use a toggle switch that you have to turn on every time you turn your key on. You turn the key on, then you flip the switch. But we're going to show you how to bypass it without a toggle switch. Now here is a 12-volt relay. This is just a standard 12-volt relay. You can get it at any stereo shop or alarm shop. You know, it's a pretty basic relay. What we're going to do is we're going to hook up wires to the top pin and the side pin, either side pin. It doesn't matter which one, okay? These side pins turn the relay on. So once there's voltage, it clicks the relay on. This side can be ground or this side can be ground, okay? Just one side needs to be grounded. It doesn't matter which side. So I usually ground pins 86, which is the side one, and 87, which is the top one. Can you see that? Alright. Now we're going to take a wire and hook it to this side one, and this is going to go to the remote wire of the head unit. Okay, this is also an amplifier turn on or a power antenna turn on. We're going to use it to turn the relay on because this wire gets power after the unit sees power. So the key turns on, the unit sees power, and then this sees power afterwards. So what that's going to do is it's going to ground the parking brake wire after the unit turns on, so you don't have to flip the switch. So basically what happens is when the relay turns on, it connects the bottom and top pins together. Okay? So now we're going to show you how that works. Now this unit's already hooked up, so this is our ground. We're just going to simply tie this ground from the relay into the radio's ground. So the unit's going to be grounded in the car, then we're tying an additional ground in for the relay. Alright? Did I explain that this would turn on an amp too at the same time? So this, if you want to turn your amp on or a power antenna, you can still tie another wire into this, and it'll turn the relay on, and it'll turn the amplifier or your power antenna on. So now what we get when we turn the key on, unit turns on, and then the relay clicks. Slightly after the unit turns on. That's what we need. Let's read in the format. It's going to see it's a DVD. And now we get a different message up with an OK button. So now you can just hit OK and the movie's playing. Okay, so you can just turn your key on and it's permanently bypassed. You know, and that's it, man. That's a bypass on the 4200 DVD. So pretty much everything. What else do we get questions on all the time?
Most likely it's going to be similar to the 3200 DVD.
Also. Oh yeah, this will also do the new 3200 DVD. AVH-P3200BT, what is that? I guess there's an AVH-P3200BT, there's a 3200 version with Bluetooth in, that'll also bypass that for audio or video input from the iPod, because that one doesn't have a DVD player. So, that's it, man. So yeah, just to go over it one more time. Pin 86 and 87 get grounded. Pin 85 goes to the blue remote wire. Parking brake wire goes to pin 30. These two side pins can be switched. It'll still work. You just want to make sure these two pins, one gets power, one gets ground, and that's going to turn on the relay to connect these two pins together. So that's all we're doing. This relay is grounding the parking brake after the unit turns on, because you don't want to ground it before the unit turns on, because it won't bypass that way. That's it. Do it.